of plaques or fat content in the vessel. So how can we stop that? How do we know? We don't know that because until it creates a symptom, we don't realize. So try to have a life, try to have a diet which prevents this clogging of the drain. Like in a kitchen drain, what happens? When the kitchen drain gets blocked, you put an acid and you drain it, pump it and get the block open. So take a diet which doesn't let these vessels block. This is going to help you for getting this blockage can be prevented at smaller age like 19. People thought that this boy is mimicking. You know, he was having pain. Everybody thought he's making jokes, you know, he's making fun of somebody. But then when he died on the spot, then they realized and the postmortem report stated that there was a coronary block. Why? Because at young age, the other supply of the heart is not there. So there is friendly supply of the heart is there. That's why a heart attack at an old age is less dangerous as compared to the heart attack under 30 years. All of us who are under 30 are more dangerously affected by coronary blocks if we have, God forbid, any time in our life. So what do? To keep on checking our heart vessels? You know how much it costs for angiography? 5,000 dirham. And if you don't have insurance, you can't check your coronaries. 5,000 dirham is a big amount. So try not to check it, okay, but try not to block it in the first place. Why to block it? So that you don't have to check it. How much is microVG?
170.
And that also lasts for 3 to 4 months. How much per month? Only 50 dirham. 50 dirham, if you can stop the clogging of your heart vessels, is it not cheap or is it not economical? Even I would charge 750 dirham if you come for the first time to my clinic. My first consultation is 750 dirham. Okay? Even microVG is 5 times cheaper. So please don't come to my clinic because you will lose 5 microVGs. Okay? So it's not that. I hope you don't get sick to go to a doctor. Anyway, so let's go to the facts that you have to improve your heart. You have to diet and do something about it. And do a respiratory system care. So you have all the things that I want to stress. Why do we need microVG? These are the reasons why do we need microVG. We need a good lung, we need a good heart, we need a good brain, and we need a good body. And all these things are affected by external factors, our lifestyle, our jobs, our family, our genes, and whatever we are eating is going to overcome all the things. So we are spoiling ourselves without knowing. Like there is a small killer inside and it's slowly, slowly killing yourself. And you are happily, you know, sitting with that killer because you don't know. So let's have something which can be more fruitful. So how many of us eat fish every day? None, nobody. Every day, only Bengali people, huh? Mostly sabo khata, right? Only Bengali bhai khata. Because it is their culture. Because they eat, and that's why you see all the Bengalis and the Bihar people who eat fish and rice without oil. They have their brains and they have their heart very strong. It is a statistical analysis that this part of the world called Bihar, Bengal, Calcutta and the other part of the southern Bengal, they are all the people where more of fish is being taken as food regularly. They have less heart attacks. They have less obesity. And they have more brain power. This is true. This is very true. It's not me. It's a scientific detail I'm giving you. Anyways, so we don't want to be this. She may look beautiful, but she is not healthy. She looked like me, no? Okay. I want to look like this someday. I can dream about it at least. So, we can take something that can kill all the diets and that can be a meal which is better than any meal. I want to have a big round of applause for microVG. These things are there in microVG. 23 ingredients and all made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. not at all a single thing is added by human to make it a medicine or to make it a food. Any other food you see in the market has been fermented, fried, you know, junk foods all, like added mayonnaise and all those making tasty things. They have colors, they have food fragrance, and all the things which are human made can have errors. It can have chemical poisons. It can have production faults. What are the production faults? Old food, frying problems, cooking, you know, all the mischiefs of the human being. Human errors can happen. But what Allah has created cannot have an error. 100%. It's, you believe it, no? You believe it. What Allah creates cannot be wrong. Only human creation can be wrong, which is man-made, which is artificially cultured, which is artificially made in the factories. The food that you see packed, we don't know how much is the expiry date. Maybe somebody has changed their mind. People do that. So how do we know what milk which we are drinking is pure milk? Even that goat, poor buffalo, is being treated with hormones. Artificial milk is being drank. Extra hormones are given to the buffaloes to make you have that fresh milk, which you call fresh, is not even good for you because it has all the hormonal imbalances which might create imbalance in your children as well. Now the milk that is being supplied, there was a study on all the milk products and they found out urea content is more because they want the milk not to be, you know, rotten. To sustain the life longevity of the milk, they used to add some chemicals. And these chemicals are not only toxic, they destroy the nutritive value of the milk. You may be happy, okay, 5 days my milk is okay. I don't have to go to the market to buy fresh milk. Long life milk. You have seen in the market? 5 days, 6 days. What do you think, what is extra in it? There are certain chemicals inside which don't make it a curdling situation. We don't make it rotten. But that is unnatural. That is completely unnatural. So how do you get milk? Even you cannot rely on meat, chicken, fish, that they are natural. Only the vegetable content can be natural only when there is no pesticide sprinkled. You know? If the packed milk, all the packed milk. Yes. So this is how we cannot even rely on it. But they seem to think that there is no immediate side effect. But they have long-term side effects. If you see the children fed on powder milk, they have more, 5 problems they are facing now. 1, they are bulky, they gain weight. You are happy, okay, powder milk is better than mother milk. Mother milk, babies are skinny, okay, no problem. I have to give top feed. Babies get chubby, they get tall, good. Everything seems to be good. But that same child, if you see and compare with the mother's milk and the child fed on a top feed, brain issues, attitude problems, autistic child, skin problems, polycystic ovarian and polycystic kidney diseases, lung problems, allergies. There is a study that if you keep on giving top feed more than 2 years, to a baby, you might end up in a baby or a boy or a girl compromised with their immunity. Because mother's milk has got GLA, which is gamma linolenic acid, which is immunizing the baby against all the problems outside, which these products they don't have. Plus they have fat content, more of carbohydrate content, and this is the international global policy that whatever milk is being held over, remaining milk in the developed countries is supplied to the underdeveloped countries because they don't want to waste it. They want to make money out of it. So this is why they send it to the third world countries, because their mothers don't want to feed. So this is one example that I can quote, the difference of natural and unnatural things. Okay, let's go and see the model of obesity, how we become obese. I don't want to go into the details, but there is some classification. If you want to know how much should be your weight, it should be your height minus 100. Your height minus 100. That means if you are 160 centimeters, your optimum weight should not be more than 65, 60 to 65. More than that, your heart is compromised, your brain is compromised, your lungs are compromised, and later your kidneys. So this is the classification. You don't want to go into that. That's the shortcut I've already told you. This is 25,000 years ago. This sculpture was Stone Age historical picture that still obesity was running. Even 25,000 years ago, people were obese. So they seemed to realize, and what they told, we don't want to look like this. No. This is what is the shape which is now coming back to us. Change of life is giving again something which we don't want to look at in the mirror. What we do? It's a big problem. Why it's a problem with the developed world? Because they have to fulfill the medical supplies. They have to give the money for the help for problems of obesity, hypertension, heart disease, diabetes. They go side by side with being overweight. 20% of the people, they have these problems. So this is the epidemiology in America, and we don't want to be one of them. So, like if I stand on the machine, it would say please one by one. Okay? So we don't want to be that. This is a study that again, they have lost life. Lifespan become less if you are overweight. So this is what I was telling you. We are happy to see this child, right? Chubby child. But it has all the more upper respiratory tract problems, lung problems, allergy, and then bulimia. And everybody says, I don't eat anything. I always say, I don't eat anything. But this is not true. Whatever we are eating is being utilized because we are not moving, we are not doing exercise. So even if we eat this much and we don't use it, it gets accumulated as a fat. So eat something which doesn't have any fat. So let's see what the obesity can give you. It can give you problems. People eat more during depression. People eat more when there is a cultural issue. People eat more when there is a genes which is letting you hungry every 4 hours. Metabolic syndrome. And some medication also can make you fat. The only thing that can be realized that if you know all these things, you can be more cautious. I am scaring you that obesity can give you all these problems from head to toe. If it includes your psychological setbacks, yes, it can be a depression. If it includes the skin problems, yes, it can give you skin problems. Brain problems, heart problems, and you name it, we have it. All these diseases can be because of obesity. So we don't want to have any of these things. Even cancer, phlebitis, arthritis, pancreatitis. So let's see. All fat people have double chance of getting sick. But we don't want to do that. So let's treat it. Let's have something in our hand which can give you the strategy to fight back. And above all, this is the screen time. How many of us sit in front of television? Everybody. I think in Gulf, when you come back from your job, there's nothing but television, right? Am I right or am I correct? Right? Right? Yes. How many of us don't want television? I think there's hardly anyone or two people who are DXNers, they don't have time to watch TV because they are doing DXN. Right? They're going for extra effort. This is the best thing DXN can take your screen time off. You know, there is a study. This screen time is the time which you spend in front of computers, which you spend in front of television. And if you spend more than 2 hours, see the what studies say. If you spend more than 2 hours, you have a triple chance of getting obese. Meaning, you will eat something while sitting television, in front of television. You don't want to go anywhere except to watch TV to relax yourself because it's too hot outside. And so many other social problems that you don't want to go around. So, inactivity is the main thing which can give you obesity. So there are trials. There are these four research trials done by the scientists, that if you increase your screen time more than 2 hours, you end up in a heart attack or physical activity, or you can increase your kilocalories to be accumulated in your body. So you increase your weight, and that is one of the reasons. So that's expenditure on your pocket. If you can gain weight, you get more sick. You get more sick, more expenditure. Your money goes for medical treatment. So this is what they do. They cut the stomach. Okay? We don't eat much. You know how much it cost? More than 200,000 dirhams. To cut your stomach into half and connect it to the lower half of the gut so that you don't eat. This is one way of cutting down the weight, which is a very expensive way and very dangerous way. To cut down an organ and to attach it to some gutter pipe so that whatever you eat goes directly out. Khalas, no absorption. No nutrition, the person get 45 kg, 50 kg loss. This is not what we want. We want something better. That is what we can get. Microwaging, that means mushrooms and vegetables. And what this means is it has all the ingredients which are very, very important, very precious, very nutritive, and very preventive, and more than medicines. Effective more than medicine. So spirulina, you know all about it. Morinzi, noni, you know all about it. Linesman, it is still there. So, connectively, except cordyceps, everything is there in mycovitae. Okay? See. What else we have? We have psyllium grains, celery, mulberry leaves. We have ginkgo leaf, we have ginger, we have lemongrass. Everybody knows about it. Right? These are really dietary fibers that we know. Nothing abnormal. Nothing medicine. All these products, shiitake mushrooms, lyophyllum mushrooms and St. George's, these are all mushrooms belonging and having the same properties like Rishi. Ganoderma. Shiitake mushroom is a bigger name. Some countries, they say that shiitake is a cousin of Ganoderma. Some say it's a father of Ganoderma. So they have all the genetic content which is same as in mushroom, our Ganoderma mushroom. So we have five types of mushrooms there, apart from our Almond Easter mushroom, Grey Easter mushroom. So they have all the properties which can give you the best nutrition and best prevention for every cell of your body. And how do it affects? I will tell you in the details. Sweet corns, lime, oranges. So you don't have to buy orange and take it in bulk, because already the fiber of orange, the content of orange, lemon itself is there in microwave. Green tea, everybody tries to drink green tea. Pericarpium. Then star anise, clove, we use it in our daily cooking. Our eastern cookings, like all biryani, korma and all these things, pulao, especially in India, Pakistan and Bangladesh, the cookings, everyday cooking, have all these things as an ingredient. So there is a reason why our senior ancestors have started using in food to give you prevention in your food. So how do you use it? One scoop of mycovitae, either mix in warm water, mix it in some juice, or have some salad, make a recipe. Have some chickpeas, have some yogurt, laban, and make it one single meal. Instead of a meal, you can take mycovitae in different forms. Especially if you can try that in Ramadan, because you don't want to eat in the morning. So just take one scoop of mycovitae, put it in water or laban, enough for the whole day. You will not eat hungry, because it will stomach it full and give you all the ingredients. Now, why it is important? Every type of ingredient, I will tell you how it improves. It has got this much content in one scoop. If you look carefully, there is little amount of carbohydrate, 4.3 grams. And all the rest are proteins, fiber and micronutrients. So it will help you to lose weight, it will help you to lose the fat content, and it will help you to decrease the fat on your blood vessels. So your blood vessels will not suffer from blood pressure, your heart will not suffer from less oxygen, your lungs will get more of nutrition and oxygenation, and apart from that, extra cellular fat will get dissolved because of lime and all this green tea. Now let's see, every part has got important functions to perform. Now psyllium seeds, it says gives you fiber. The fiber will wash the intestine. It is important for your diarrhea. It is important for your constipation. That means any sort of problem in your intestine, if you take mycoveggie, you can get rid of all these problems. So that means everybody can take it. Normal person, people with diarrhea, people with constipation. So it will treat constipation, it will treat diarrhea, and it will help you to get rid of extra fat also. The psyllium has got lots of folate properties that is people have been using for thousands of years now. It is known as isbaghol in Urdu, isbaghol husk in English, and it is used as fiber containing things during diarrhea and constipation as well. Normally people use it separately. And what is done, it produces gelatin, which is giving you to cross over the waste products outside. How it helps? It can, now lots of studies there, it can also prevent cancer of the colon. So only psyllium, one content of mycoveggie, can prevent cancer of the colon. So you can imagine how much the other product can help you. Plus, it will, all this is a part of that treatment of only psyllium. You see the list? Hemorrhoids, cholesterol, diabetes, blood pressure, heart, cancer, and all sort of intestinal problems. Only psyllium can take care. And psyllium is there as a part of mycoveggie. Then, how to take it? Drink at least extra 6 to 8 glass of water because of psyllium. Because psyllium needs water, and water has to be increased in a normal diet also, but you are taking mycoveggie to add more of your water content. Now celery. Celery is a vegetable which takes care of your urinary tract. It prevents your urinary infections, it prevents arthritis, and it prevents nervous exhaustion. You don't get tired. So it's not a bad thing that means. It is giving you good effect, better than medicine. Then mulberry. Even today, you know, there is a syrup of mulberry. Now you see lots of people are having sore throat. Cough is there in the season. High grade fever and productive cough. Mulberry is going to take all the toxins of the environment and gives you a clarity of energies. So you have mulberry leaves. It activates the immune system, it improves your circulatory system, and it improves the bladder infections. How it benefits? It can reduce asthmatic attacks. If you see a person who has got an asthmatic attack, my lungs are okay. Because it seems as if he is about to die. If you don't give oxygen to an asthmatic person, people will get death on the, even with a few seconds. Because the congestion, the chest, which is depriving them of oxygen, for 3 minutes, if they don't get the oxygen, the brain damage occurs. So you can imagine how important oxygenation of a cell is. So it can prevent asthma, it can prevent cholesterol, and prevent the oxidation also of the cellular level. So if you see, it keeps you healthy, it kills the bacteria, and also it can form the lung cells, get they expand. When they expand, better breathing. When the lung capillaries expand, you breathe better. That's why it is effective in asthmatic patients. Also, it can give you a reduction of ulcers, stomach ulcers, anti-aging factors, and reducing the cholesterol. Then ginkgo biloba. Ginkgo biloba, now 90% of your medicines, they contain ginkgo now. It has very good effect on brain. Forgetfulness, you know, when you get aged, you start losing your memory. And a time comes, you become an Alzheimer, especially women. When they have their hormone coming down, they lose their content of memory. They can memorize, but sometimes, even now you see, if you try to look for something, oh, where did I see this? What was the name of this one? Right? Even young children are forgetting now. Because we are concentrating on so many things at the same time. Plus, the aging process is getting so fast now. If you see a boy of 5 years today and a boy of 5 years 20 years back, there's a lot of difference in brain activity. So the fast aging at the cell level is killing people. So how do you do know that? You start forgetting at an earlier age. At the age of 45, at the age of 50, your memory is going down. How do you prevent that? There is no drug that can prevent memory loss. Only thing is you keep memorizing. You keep having notebooks with you so that you don't forget what you are doing. So how do you do that? You add something in your diet to make your brain cells active, not to go to that aging process. So this is what anti-vertigo. You get vertigo. That also is preventable. The ginkgo and ginger. Everybody knows ginger. And everybody knows the grandma recipes of ginger. When you have cough, when you have upper respiratory tract infection, you take ginger in tea, you take ginger in milk, right? Because you want to get rid of all the toxins from the lungs. But now it has given us lots of properties. Ginger can give you prevention from nausea in pregnancy. Ginger can give you the treatment of stomach problems, headache, flu, inflammation, joint problems. You see, there's a hell of a beauty involved in the food. And we take that advantage of ginger and microwave. And then lemongrass, nervous system, stress, lemongrass can take care. Shiitake mushrooms, like any other big mushrooms, anti-tumor, antiviral, anti-allergic, anti-arthritic. Immunological definitely improves your resistance. And lime, we love lime because nothing is tasty without lemon, right? You make salad with lemon, you make recipes with lemon to make it tasty, but it has got a huge content of vitamin C, which makes you immune to so many diseases, and it has water and protein. Fat is very less, 0.2 gram. This is all the content in oranges. So it's a blessing. Doctors promote, take fruits. How many oranges you can eat? 4, 5, 6. But if you take one scoop of mycoveggie, you can get all the things in one scoop. You don't have to go to the market and buy and take the vegetables, which are already having pesticides on them, which are already not sure that they are pure vegetable. So these are the things that can benefit you. If you see here, the benefits of all these thymine, B12, B3, B5. B5 is so much necessary for your fertility. B6 for your nerves. Folic acid for your blood. Vitamin C, calcium, iron, magnesium, phosphorus, and so many things are there in orange. So orange is one of the very friendly fruit. And none of us usually take oranges so much that can fulfill the whole body requirement. And if you take microwave regularly, you can get so much of orange inside. Green tea controls bleeding, wound healing, temperature, sugar, and digestion. And also, it's a weight watcher. It watches your weight. People drink green tea after food not to gain weight. And also, it's a very good antioxidant. It prevents the heart, it prevents the bloatments, and you see indigestion, stimulation, and the side effects of addiction. People who have smoking addiction, alcohol addiction, if you give them green tea regularly, they can get rid of addiction very smoothly. So that way, we can help with mycoveggie also. And other uses, urinary infections, fatigue, tiredness. There's another thing, pericarpium. It has got important effects on your sputum. People who are having a lot of sputum, they can take the advantage of that inside. Cinnamon. Cinnamon has got common cold, anti-common cold properties, prevents indigestion, bad breath, toothache. And even people use it in tea, people use it in food, and rheumatism, and people sometimes chew in pan. In India, Pakistan, and Bangladesh, cinnamon is being used when you have cough in raw betel, betel leaf. पान के अंदर डाल के वो खाते हैं ताकि वो गला जो है उसको सही ये जितने सिंगर्स हैं ना यू सी ऑल द कव्वाल एंड ऑल दे टेक मुलेठी एंड सिनेमन रेगुलरली टू प्रिवेंट द स्वेलिंग ऑफ द कॉर्ड्स टू प्रिवेंट देयर कंट्रोल ऑफ लंग्स बिकॉज व्हेन दे स्क्रीम व्हेन दे शाउट दे नीड्स अ लॉन्ग कैपेसिटी ऑफ द लंग एंड एयर एंट्री into their vocal cords. And they continuously insult the vocal cords by speaking very loudly. Every now and then the cords become thick. They take cinnamon regularly so that the swelling of the cord becomes less, the voice becomes good, and they can sustain that. But this is in their natural right. Clove, very good painkiller, anti-helminthic. It kills your worms, it kills your germs, and it is natural toothache. If you have a tooth problem and you are not a deep sinner, you take clove, put it on the painful tooth, and just spit out the saliva. That swelling will go off. If you have throat problem, just put cloves in your gum, take it there, slowly, slowly swallow, your throat will get no irritation. So this is the property of natural things which are there in, we are using in terms of microbiology. So if you wish to lose weight, we recommend at least only 1000 to 1200 kilocalories a day, and the rest of the food should be taken as microbiology, which has got very less calories, but more importantly, it has all the products which can give you nutrition, prevention, aggravation of your health care without any doctor. So if you get motivated, you drink a lot of water and keep that, once you open it, you keep it in the fridge so that it doesn't get rotten because it has got all the food content. So microbiology is very low in fat. It has no sugar, minimal sugar, cholesterol free, high in fiber, higher in vitamins, especially vitamin C and calcium, and high content in iron. People who are anemic, they can, you know, take microbiology even as a part of treatment. So these things which we can rely on content of microbiology to, let's have the exteriorization of the toxins from your body, and that's why you can control your body weight also. Now these are the researches that are not through DXL. These are the researches done by other scientists when they control the diet through these contents. And you can go into individual formats from where this presentation has been made. So I hope you have understood some of the microbiology and the references, microbiology bottles and all these things. You know about senior people who have done a lot of research on microbiology, and you can take the, you know, I am thankful to all these people who have made my life easy by doing the research. Some of the things I did, rest of 80% they did. So it gave me less time to make it for you easy to understand. And I wish I was not too much scientific about it. But I wish if 80% of you have understood, maybe 10% of what I have told you, you would love microbiology from now onwards. Because that can change your life. In about months' time, you will see the change in your life. In the quality of your breath, in the quality of your digestion, in the quality of your memory, and in the quality of your long-term illnesses. I'm 100% sure if you make it as a regular diet, you will not go to a doctor, inshallah. This is alhamdulillah, God bless you. Thank you very much for your patient hearing, and if you have any questions, you are most welcome to ask. Thank you.